Hi dudes, I'm Edoardo, and today we are going to see how to calibrate the extruder estrusore per millimeter of any 3D printer that runs MARLIN or any compatible firmware, in my case from my anet. If you have printed a cube and tried adjusting these tips, you are just guessing at values. To get the right estrusore per millimeter of your extruder, you have to compare how much material the printer put out with the length of the material actually requested.
Get yourself a ruler and a permanent marker for this procedure. Measure 150 mm of filament from the top of the extruder stepper motor and mark it with the permanent marker. Next, you need to send the command to extrude 100 mm of filament to the printer. You can do it using the printer's display or via command line with the software like AutoPrint, Printerface, RapidRost, etc. I'm going to use the last one. First of all, send the command Z92EZO to set the current position of the extruder at 0. You probably don't actually need to zero extruder position, but I recommend it. Then send the command Z1E100F90. Maybe you have to set the parameter F230 if you're using a 3 mm filament. In this case, the command becomes Z1E100F30. After waiting for the end of the previous command, you have to measure the distance between the mark and the top of the extruder stepper motor, and then subtract it from 150 mm. This value should be 100. If not, you'll need to fix this gap. To get your current estrusore, you have to send the command M503 and search it from the output. To calculate the new value, you have to multiply the old value by 100 and divide by the distance measured before. This is your new estrusore per millimeter value. To store it and overwrite your current value, use the command M92 with the argument E set to your new value. In my case, M92E100. In this way, the value is temporarily overwritten. To make the edit permanent, send the command M500. At this point, you can repeat the calibration of the extruder and check that the gap between measures is null.
Be sure that the filament's diameter is the same as specified on the roll of that filament. If not, you would have over-extrusion or under-extrusion problems. In case that the diameter is greater, you should increase the flow parameter in your slicer and vice versa. A rule of thumb does not exist. The secret is try and try again. I hope you'll find this tutorial helpful. For any question, please write me in the comments below and see you next time. Bye!